Hello, this is Corey with the Painted Peacock, and this is another paint night, well, paint party demo. This one was really interesting. I'm going to show you the good, the bad, and the very, very ugly. I've started my canvas doing all brilliant blue. I'm going to do a nighttime hot air balloon scene, adding a little white to my middle and then pushing it out, creating an ombre effect. That was so quick and so easy. I'm kind of surprised I didn't grow a brain and figure it out before. Doing a little bit of black on the top and the bottom. I am pleased as punch about how the background turned out. I'm gonna add a few stars using a toothbrush. And since this is a horizon, I'm gonna take my black and we are creating that horizon. Going to do a few hills. Boop, boop, boop. Fantastic. I've decided that I'm going to do 5 balloons. This is going to be my largest one. I've seen hot air balloons before, and they are not the same shape as a child's balloon, as a latex. They have a tendency to be a little more egg-shaped. I have done them white initially because I wanted to make them look like they're glowing. And doing white is the best way to negate that dark background I've already put there. Clear up in the corner here. And I want these a little bit larger. I'm gonna do one more over here. And because I am working over water, I've decided, well, let's go ahead and do some reflection. Apparently later. So I'm doing my yellow. Again, I want them to appear to be glowing. Now, usually when I paint, I just kind of trust the process and let myself work its way through. This is a really excellent example on how that didn't go so well. I was a good girl and did dry it off before I tried to continue. And now we work on that reflection a little bit. And that's going to be wavy because it is in the water and won't perfectly reflect what is above. Adding that yellow to mimic what we have going on above. And it's just kind of looking sort of funky. I did grab some vermilion and adding some color stripes. I was thinking that I can do the shape of the balloon and it would give kind of a striping effect. What it did create was a bit of a hot mess, but I've learned to trust the process, and so we're just going to kind of keep fiddling with the paint to see if we can improve things. I'm going in, little correction here, and it didn't get any better. So fun. I'm gonna go in with a red and try and hone in the shape a little bit. And then I thought, oh, mercy, this isn't going well. Well, let's try and do some of the lines that are in the hot air balloon to see how I feel about that. Oops, no, still not going well. But we trust the process. Let's go in for some distinct lines. Just to get that hot air balloon shape. Oh. Oh yes, I realized something. I hate it. Let's block it out and try again. I'm gonna go ahead and change the shape of these down here. Just let them bleed out a little more naturally into the water and try and refrain from being so mimicking. Oh, that's not a word, but I just made it up. Mimic the shape of the balloons. I do want that yellow in there, so we're gonna try again. the dream is to glow. So we've decided let's do a few more layers, and let's do a little darker yellow. And now let's do a little orange. I went with traditional orange so it wouldn't be quite as dark as the vermilion. Painting it on. Oh, look. I have accidental candy corn in the sky. We'll just keep going. I'm going to add a little bit of that crimson again. Things are going all right. I feel better about it anyway. Just a little bit of that striping to pull it down. And put a little fire at the bottom of each of those baskets. And we're done. It was a struggle, but we made it. Thank you for watching.